How instinctively we react to negative stimuli in our environment, or to be less clinical about it, what we do to make our lives a little better, is really quite remarkable. If you've got sun in your eye, you cross the street to where it's less bright. If it's too hot, you walk in the shade. And if you live in the city, you don't really think about how many of those instincts are in response to nature. Urban forests are as much a part of cityscapes as skyscrapers. They're as vital to the lives of city residents as public transport. We just don't tend to notice them. They don't really draw attention to themselves, and they're usually not as obvious as actual forests like this, the Prospect Park Ravine in Brooklyn. But they're everywhere. Urban forests are landscaped boulevards, they're river promenades, they're even backyards. They're the trees that line our streets. Every time you cross the street to walk in the shade, you're interacting with an urban forest. And that shade is important. The New School's Urban Systems Labs recently sent a satellite over New York City to record variations in temperature and found that in industrial working-class neighborhoods like Bushwick, Brooklyn, temperatures can be up to 20 degrees Fahrenheit warmer than in the tree-lined neighborhoods surrounding parks. That's something I found really hard to believe at first, but there's tons of evidence that it's true, and not just here in New York City. The San Diego-based public broadcast program, A Growing Passion, recently investigated this phenomenon, and
it means there's like a 30-degree difference between the asphalt and the concrete here, and 20 degrees between here and the concrete in the sunny area without the shade.
Just 25 years ago, the forest here was in danger of being lost forever, in part because of natural processes like erosion, and in part because of human intervention and, well, crime. So the Prospect Park Alliance closed it off to visitors and revitalized it to the forest it is today. I actually remember that restoration process. My first grade class planted a tree here, but I could never find it. Still, despite the success of this particular project, urban forests across the city remain threatened. That's why the Natural Areas Conservancy is leading NYC parks and other organizations in a 25-year, $385 million effort to revitalize them. And with good reason. Urban forests are vital to mitigating climate change in cities. Trees are like air conditioners. They help counter the heat island effect, the reason urban areas absorb more heat than rural areas and feel warmer. Every year, trees in New York City absorb almost 2 billion gallons of stormwater runoff and evaporate most of it through their leaves, and evaporation is a cooling process. They store 1.2 million tons of carbon and remove 1,300 tons of pollutants from the atmosphere each year in New York. Currently, 40% of New York City is green in some way, whether that's natural areas, backyards, or cemeteries. There are over 10.5 thousand acres of forests, mostly in the city's 124 public parks, and 7 million trees. In addition to cleaner air and UV absorption, trees alter cities' acoustics. If cities lost their trees, residents would have to deal with higher wind speeds, warmer temperatures, and life would be a lot louder than it already is. People like to say that the ravine is the one area in Prospect Park where you can't hear traffic, and you can't. That doesn't mean they filter out helicopters and airplanes, though. But it is a lot cooler here. The success of revitalizing Prospect Park's ravine over the past 25 years is a good indicator that with some well-intentioned financial and community support, urban forests across the city will return to health and stability in the 25 years to come. Of course, urban forests aren't a solution to climate change, but as global temperatures rise, they'll continue to make life in the city a little more bearable for the next few decades or so, until we can agree on something more permanent. And they really are beautiful.